What's up, guys? Welcome back to Virtual Reality. Finally, I can show you a full review of the Valve Index headset. And I can tell you why this is a good, but by far not a perfect headset. That's it. My name is Voodoo. You can find hardware tests, gameplays, news and events, VR and AR related on my channel. So subscribe, hit the bell and don't miss anything. Thanks to my official Patreon sponsors, Woodghost VR, Dungy Gamer, Oberon Events and Peter Wasmeyer. So, we will go through a big list of points that so that I can show you everything about this headset, like design, comfort, setup, display, controller, lenses, heat and IPD adjustment, people wearing glasses and so on and so on. You will know everything about this headset after this review. So let's have some fun and let's go! Voodoo.de. Let's first talk about the design and quality of the material. So for the design, of course, everybody has another opinion. For me, the Valve Index doesn't look very good. For me, it's a little bit ugly because these two cameras look like eyes that are very far away from each other. And from the side, it looks like there's a small pin. I don't know. It looks a little bit strange, like a small elephant. I don't know. However, this doesn't matter. The front, I don't love the front because you see the fingerprints here. And also, I hope I can show you this. Yeah, you see that here, there, the scratches. Even when I didn't touch it from the unboxing, there was still scratches of this cover here. And there is no cover above this. So this is bad. This is bad. However, guys, the material quality is awesome. When you compare it to the Pimax, where a lot of gaps here and stuff, this is completely the same gap. There is no difference here. It's perfect. The design is what we would expect for a high quality headset, the strap as well. Also this design that you can just flip that out with a magnet, this is perfect. Also the headphones here with the metal design and the foam is awesome. Look at this, the strap, and also the cable design. Look at this, it's here and there with the clips. The cable feels good. The cable is 6 meters long. I think this is 20 feet when you compare it. Also the slider and everything, it's very good quality. So in this category, I really love the Valve Index. Let's talk about the comfort of this device. So of course, everybody has another shape of the head and stuff. For me, I have the people that know me, I have a very big head. I call this an alien skull. So I have to put it to the limit mostly, and then I can put it. You better put that up, then push this to your face and then put it down again and then use the screw and then the strap here. So this is really, for me, this is very comfortable, really, guys. So the material sits here, that's awesome, absolutely no problem. Then you can adjust the headphones here. Don't try to push them closer to your ears, they will perhaps break, I don't know. They are not supposed to lie on your ears. They fly over your ears. That's very important. So it's very comfortable. And there's another thing, I didn't even know that. This is another part that you can use. You can push that inside here and then you can also wear the headset. But to be honest, this is not really comfortable for me. So I will not play with this part. And I really have no idea what that is supposed for. The first thing I thought is because the distance is closer, this is for smaller heads or even for children to play with this device. I don't know. I will not use that. But if you have a small head, just put it inside here and then you have no problems anymore. So the Valve Index is a very comfortable headset for me.
Let's talk about the weight. So I put that on a scale. The five headsets you can see here, and the lightest headsets of these five is the Rift S with 579 grams. So this is very light. Then the Samsung Odyssey Plus with 601 gram. Then the Pimax, but I attached the Deluxe Audio Strap because later there will be a Deluxe Audio Strap for the Pimax, so that was fair. So this is 764 gram. Then comes the Valve Index with 788 grams, so it's pretty heavy. And then on the heaviest headset is the Vive Pro with 864, but there are two small the coolers installed, so without them I would say 820 grams, but the Vive Pro is the heaviest headset. However, the Index is not really, it's not uncomfortable, it's pretty heavy, but you don't notice that. That's very good. Okay, let's talk about the setup. How can we make the Valve Index work? So if you already connected the base stations to the walls with screws or with tripods, however you want to do that, then you connect them with the power cord and then connect the Index headset and switch on the controllers. Then download Steam VR. This is just an app, you can search that in the Steam store or check out your email when your Valve Index was shipped. There is also a link to the Steam VR app. So when you open this, it looks like this, but before you start, there will be a little I letter on all of these three symbols. That means there is a firmware upgrade available. Do this. This is important. The headset is already connected, so this is not a problem. And the controllers must be connected via the USB cable that comes with your headset, and then update the firmware, restart Steam VR, and then it should look like this here. And then you can see, sorry for the German stuff here, I cannot change that. I have no idea how. However, this is a room scale VR, this is seated VR. So of course I will choose a room scale VR, and then it says you need a minimum space of 2 by 1.5 meters. So now it says activate tracking, and here you see the first controller, the second controller, the headset is available. Oh, one of them turned out, turned off just because there is a timeout. The other one should turn off soon as well. However, they must, of course, all be activated. Then, now I can't show you what happens because you cannot record this. It says, please remove your headset and stuff. And what you're gonna do is hold your trigger and walk around the area where your play space will be. This is everything is listed here, and then you will see what happens. This is not a problem. I cannot show you this, unfortunately, now. So yeah, I will do this now, and then let's continue. Okay, and when everything is finished, then it should look like this here. The window is removed, and you only see this here. And when you look into the headset, you will see this. This is a dark environment, and this is the Steam VR start environment. But let's check out the settings. So what we can do here is, the most people know this already. Here we can switch the audio devices, the microphone and the headphones, if you like that. But this is the most important thing here. So you can switch the refresh rate. This is the most important thing at the Valve Index. Normally you go to 90 Hertz. You have to restart Steam every time, but here we can even go to 144 Hertz. Holy moly. And this is what I will test, and I will tell you my opinion about the difference of that. You cannot record this, of course. You will not see the difference in the recording, but I will tell you my opinion. I will play this in the three modes. And yes, of course, we can then here switch the resolution if we like. If you have a powerful PC, you can even get higher to resolutions of 4508 by 5008. But I will leave it at the standard settings for now. This is for me 2468 by 2740. Very interesting. Here we can switch the cameras of the Valve Index on and off, Bluetooth on and off, base stations, power settings, USB, and here are some developer settings. You know this already perhaps from the Vive or stuff. Very interesting. So yeah, then we can close this stuff and we can start playing VR now. Ha! Let's see the technical data. And I compared 5 headsets. So the Valve Index has the highest hertz with 144 possible, and the others are from 80 to 90. As you can see, the resolution of the Index, the Odyssey Plus and the Vive Pro are exactly the same, and the Pimax has a little bit bigger resolution with 2560 by 1440, and the Rift S a little slighter resolution. So from the technical data, the Rift S is the worst, and yeah, and the Valve Index compared with the Pimax is the best. So yeah, what can we tell about that? So I will show you some pictures through the lens so you can see the screen, the effect, the colors and all the stuff. This is very important to see. Let's talk about the screen door effect. So I compared 5 very different headsets, as you can see here. And yeah, let's talk about this. So where can you see the most pixels? Yes, the Pimax OLED, of course. Even though it has a big resolution, a high resolution, you can see the pixels very, very good. This is because of the bad OLED display. They don't have a good one. So there's the worst screen door effect. Then, and the best screen door effect, where you can't see any pixels, is the Odyssey Plus, but it, this has, this cover over the lens so that you can't see the screen door effect. But then you, it's on the other way, it looks very blurry. It looks more blurry than all the other headsets, the Odyssey Plus. And when we compare, I would say the Valve Index has pretty the same screen door effect than the Rift S, perhaps a little bit better. But on all these headsets, besides the Pimax OLED, you cannot really see the pixels. It only when you really concentrate to see them, then you can see them. But normally when during the gameplay, you don't see that very much. The best screen door effect for me still has the Pimax 5K Plus and the Pimax 8K. That's it for the screen door effect. Let's talk about how you can read small text with these VR headsets. So a lot of people ask me in simulations where you have a cockpit with small text and stuff, how is that possible to read that with the headsets? And here are the results filmed through the lens. I had some text and I filmed it through the lens. So as you can see, the Pimax 5K Plus has the worst result. How is that possible? This is because for the Pimax 5K, because of the very big field of view, the large displays, you need a lot of resolution. You have to raise the resolution so much that not really any graphics card can master this. So I choose a resolution that is pretty okay for my 2080 Ti, but the results, you see that in the middle, on the top, and this is not very good. Perhaps in the next next generation of graphic cards, this will be better. But for now, this is a big problem with the Pimax headsets. And then you see the other headsets. They are close together, but look at the Valve Index. This is definitely the clearest view of all these headsets for the text readability. So if you want to play simulations or really want to read text or even want to use virtual desktop, then you should really go for the Valve Index. This is very interesting and you can see the results here. When we talk about the colors, I filmed these pictures through the lens of the testing tool, and it's very hard to decide here, to be honest. All of these headsets have good, acceptable colors. But if I could decide, I would say the Vive Pro has the best colors. We can argue about this, of course. And the worst colors has the Rift S. So this is my opinion. But however, there's no big difference between them. In the middle, somewhere in the middle is the Valve Index. And I didn't notice any problems with the colors here as well. So this is not a big problem with any of these headsets. Okay, and let's talk about the God Ray effects. These effects occur mostly when white text is in front of black background, like this here. This is a special glare test, a God Ray test. And yeah, we have to be honest here, the Valve Index is not good in this category, really not good. Look at this. So I filmed this through the lens of all these headsets, and you can't see it compared to the Vive Pro. It has also bad God rays. The Valve Index is not good here, really not good. I don't like this. Even when I didn't do this test, when I didn't concentrate on the God Ray test, the first thing I played with the Valve Index was Beat Saber. And when you start the game, there's this big Beat Saber logo. And I noticed, wow, what the heck is that? A lot of God Rays with the Valve Index. So this is not good. This is really not good. The sweet spot, okay. There is... This is better when you don't think about the God rays. There is nothing warping or distortion or anything with the Valve Index. Not like the Pimax where you have this little distortion at the sides. The Valve Index doesn't have the distortion. I didn't notice that. The worst sweet spot here is at the Odyssey Plus for me. You have to find the sweet spot. In several minutes sometimes. So yeah, for the God Rays, oh no, this is not good, Valve. Really not. Let's talk about the black levels, guys. Very important when you play dark games like Elite Dangerous or horror games or even Beat Saber, because there are dark scenes. So what you can see here is filmed through the lens, and of course the OLED displays have the best black levels. You can see that with the Vive Pro and the Odyssey Plus. This is real black. Then the worst black levels has the 5K Pimax. So you can see that this is not fun to play dark games like Paranormal Activity, Lost Soul, or Elite Dangerous or stuff. So very bad. And the other two, the Rift S and the Valve Index, are pretty the same, I would say, from the black levels. You notice that when I play with the headset, with the Valve Index, I notice that I'm using an LC display. I noticed that in Beat Saber. I noticed that in the Steam environment. But I think after a few minutes, you can forget this. Okay, this is not very bad with the Valve Index. You see it, but it's not too bad. So yeah, you can see the comparison here. Okay, let's talk about a feature that many people say it's a killer feature of the Valve Index, the high hertz count. So as you can see here, you can choose between 80, 90, 120 and 144 hertz. So there's no other headset that has 144 hertz. So I was really interested in that. I was looking forward to try that because everybody told, wow, that's awesome. I tried Beat Saber. Guys, I cannot show this to you because it's impossible to show 144 hertz on YouTube. So I don't even try to show this. Just believe me, please. I can't show this to you. So when I played Beat Saber first time on 90 hertz, it was a normal gameplay. And then I put that on 144 hertz, and I expected something like, wow, this is awesome. But this did not happen, guys. I don't see a big difference in the games from 90 to 144 hertz in the game. I also tried Always VR, Onward, and all this stuff. In the game, I don't really see a big difference. The only difference I see is when I move the controller fast. Then I can see the difference, but nothing else. So this is, for me, not the killer feature that everybody talking about. For me, not. So perhaps, of course, when you play like 4 hours or what, then it's a little bit better for the eyes. But even then, I played some hours, but the difference is not so big that I would say this is a killer feature. Never, ever. And when we talk about the hertz, we need to talk about the performance. So for the 144 hertz mode needs a high-end PC, guys. Even my PC, I have 9900K and 2080 Ti graphics card. It was struggling sometimes. Sometimes a little bit stuttering. It was okay, but I noticed that my graphic card is at the limit. So don't play this if you don't have a high-end PC. For the people that have a 1080 or 1080 Ti, I would say the 90 hertz mode is fine. You can play it with that, but please notice that the Valve Index is a little, I won't say high-end, but yeah, it's close to high-end. So don't play with the Index with a low-end PC. That doesn't make sense. Go for the Rift S or whatever when you have a low-end PC. And this is my opinion. So a 1080 or 1080 Ti should be okay for the Valve Index and the 6700K. If you want to go for 144 Hz, buy a high-end PC, guys. That's it for Hertz and performance. Let's talk about the field of view. This is very important because, you know, Valve told us it has 130 degrees diagonal field of view. This is more than with the Vive and the Vive Pro that has 110. So diagonal, guys, that this is important. It's a very big difference between horizontal and vertical. So I use the test tool as always, and here are the results. Of course, the Pimax has the biggest field of view. There is no talking about this. Of course, the Pimax is much better than all the other headsets here. And even on normal, it's 140 horizontal, and you can even put it on large, then it's even bigger. So, however, the vertical field of view is pretty much the same with all the headsets. Only difference is the horizontal field of view. And here you can see that the Valve Index has 110 compared to the Vive Pro that has 94. So this is a difference of 16 degrees. And this is so much noticeable. I didn't expect that, to be honest, because I used the Pimax since months, and I love the big field of view, and I didn't know, is that good, the Valve Index? And yes, it's the field of view is much bigger than with the Rift S, Vive or Vive Pro or all these headsets. So if you want a bigger field of view, you can go for the Valve Index if you don't want the Pimax 5K or 8K or any Pimax headset. It's totally worth it. You will definitely notice the difference, but only if the lenses are very close to your eyes, of course. I can recommend to put the Valve Index as close to your eyes as possible, of course. Otherwise, you will lose the field of view, of course, if you get far away from that. So this value I measured, 110, is with the closest possible settings. I'm totally happy about the field of view of the Valve Index. This is a good sign. I really love this.
Okay, let's test the light leakage. Will there be some light coming in from the sides or from beneath? That's very important, so let's put that on my head. I switched on all the lights here so that I can see that very good. So yeah, let's see. So there is no light coming inside, not from the side and not from the bottom. Only if you move your nose a little bit, you can see a little spot here, the green ground here, but no, it's totally fine. There is nothing coming in here, so this is not a problem.
Okay, let's try the Index controllers now. As you can see, I have that on my hands here, and let's check out the tracking of the controllers. This is really good. So you know this from the Lighthouse system, there is absolutely no problem when we hold it behind our head or that is tracked perfect, okay? Even when we hold it in front of each other, there is absolutely no problem. That shaking is my hand. I can't hold still. So this is really, really good to play games like Onward, where you have to aim
precise and stuff. This is perfect, as we know that from the Vive controllers as well. Everything that works over Lighthouse is perfect tracking. So, but let's check out the tracking of the fingers. So, this is a really hard procedure to make this work. I didn't expect that. So, there's a lot of settings here where you have to really put your hands on the right place. So, there are four settings here, and on the other side, also four settings. And look at this. This is how you align the controllers to your hands. And they are not loose. I don't touch them, and I can throw that and it won't fly away. It's awesome. It's really good. But to find the perfect position for your hands so that they are tracked, you need several minutes for this. So this is my small finger, next finger, middle finger. Do you see that? The middle finger. Sometimes the wrong finger is tracked because my hands are on the wrong position again. So you have to play around with that stuff. This is my index finger and the thumb. So we have a fist, my small finger, middle finger. Index finger, thumb. That works pretty good as long as you have it on the correct place. You have to play around with that. This is very important. Otherwise, the wrong fingers will be tracked. However, the controllers are pretty comfortable. You cannot reach the menu button very good because this is very hidden here. But this is really good, so you don't push the button accidentally. This is really awesome. The trackpad is very small, so this is not like with the Vive controllers that you have a big touchpad, but you have you can see the thumbsticks where I can teleport around and stuff, the buttons, you even notice when I push them. So this is pretty interesting here. I'm excited about this. It works good. And you can of course grab stuff, throw it away, and this is really awesome. They are pretty good, but you have to handle with it a few minutes before they work. This is the tracking of the Valve Index. And what I also wanted to say is that I'm recording now with the included integrated microphone of the Valve Index. So this is the sound of the Valve Index. If that sounds bad, it's not my fault. I just wanted to show you this, how it sounds. So I really hope this is good. Okay, guys, and now I want to show you the Index controllers in a real game. So Onboard has full Index controller support. Look at this. This is awesome. So everything works fine here. So you have to get to used to that. It's totally different than before. It's much better than before. So if you want to grab this weapon, you don't have to push a grip button. You just grab it. You see that? You just grab it. Awesome. And then here also, and then you can shoot. This is so amazing. How can I... what was that again? Ah, here, okay. And then I can throw this away. So cool. Look, I don't have to push any button. I grab this magazine here and then throw it away. Wow, this is so much more immersion. Holy moly. for now, I have the setting that you don't have to hold the grip button, but it's better, of course, if you change that. But for me, I can play it better when I put it like this. So, wow, this is crazy. For me, the Index controllers are the killer feature of the Valve Index set, to be honest. Awesome. That's cool. Yeah, that's what I wanted to show you. It works just fine. It's like intended. Awesome. However, there is also a disadvantage of the Index controller, guys. So if you want to pull the trigger, it makes a strange noise. Hear this. So this is too loud for me. So So I can even hear this when I have the headphones of the Valve Index over my ears. I can hear that. So it kills a little bit of the immersion. So just put your volume on maximum or what, so you don't hear this anymore. A little disadvantage. Okay, let's talk about the heat of this. So can you play hours and hours without sweating? So guys, I have to be honest, in this category, this is the worst headset I ever tried. So it's extremely hot. When you remove the faceplate and touch this here, this is so hot. I can't touch it, okay? But it's very, very hot. And if I put it on my face like this, I can, and then I close it, and then I can even feel on my forehead here that it's getting very hot. So this is coming definitely from the displays, and if you sweat a lot, this will be a big problem, guys. I'm sweating a lot, so after 5 minutes, I'm totally sweated, and this is a problem perhaps for you. If you don't sweat much, this will not be a problem, but you really have to notice that. So playing 2 hours, I think this is impossible for me with the Valve Index. Perhaps they can fix that, I don't know, but for now, this is getting too hot for me to play long. Of course, I can play 1 hour. I'm sweating, I could play, but it's not really comfortable to get all this heat. So yeah, that's it. Let's talk about the IPD. So you have a slider here. You can move this slider up and down and then look at the lenses. So when you have SteamVR activated and you have it on your head and you move the slider, you can see the current IPD value inside the headset. And the value, the range goes from 58 millimeters to 70. So I think the Quest has 58 to 72. So this is a little bit smaller, the range. So for people that perhaps have a very big IPD, so like a 74 or something like that, could perhaps be a small problem. I don't know, I cannot test it because I have 60. For me, it's absolutely no problem. But yeah, that's it, 58 to 70. Let's try out if this big glasses fits under the Valve Index. Look at this, very big. So very important is that you push the lenses most far away from your eyes before you put that on your face. Then put this up, go under the headset, put this down, screw, and this screw, be careful that you don't scratch your lenses, and now it's perfect. It fits perfect under this headset, absolutely no problems. If you want to remove it, put it up and then remove it from your head, perfect. Let's talk about the sound. So this is totally different than all other headsets you are familiar with. So if I can show you, do you see that now? I think so, yes. They are not touching your ears. They are flying over your ears. They are, I can't measure that. I think it's like 2 or 3 centimeters away from your ears. And so you can hear your environment. This is, for me, that's good. And the sound is very, very good. Really, guys, this is the best sound and the best quality of headphones that I ever had on a VR headset. So yes, this is awesome. And I can totally recommend to not use your own headphones or headset. But if you don't like it, that you can still hear your environment because you want over-ear headphones, then you can remove them and put your own headphones there. But for me, this is perfect. This is the best what I ever experienced at a VR headset. So let's talk about the connectors, audio, and VR equipment that you can use. So if you want to remove the cable, you have this little clip here, just pull it away. Then the cable is loose here, then you have to lift it on here, then it's completely loose, then remove the face cover. This is magnetic, this is really good. You can wash it here with a cloth or something like that. This is absolutely possible, but you cannot remove the face, the foam here from this plastic. This doesn't work, but you, I think you can reorder this in the shop later if that gets broken or whatever. So, and then you have to pull the cable out here. So you have the cable here. This is the connector of the cable. Then you can pull this up. And here you can see the connectors. This is what I just removed. And here's the audio connector. So if you remove here this screw and this screw, you can remove the included headset and use your own. But guys, the guys who want to use a Bluetooth headset, this does not work. It's not listed as a Bluetooth device or Bluetooth dongle in Windows, so you cannot connect a Bluetooth device. It didn't work for me. The Index has Bluetooth, but it's only for the controllers. So this is the connectors here inside. If you want to clean you need some Q-tips for your ears perhaps, because it's very narrow here, and some rubber stuff. This is only with a Q-tip. Then on the front you can remove this cover, and here you have a USB port. This will be for future equipment and some modules that we have no idea, perhaps wireless or something like that. I don't know. So yeah, the next thing is, give me a second, you can use the VR equipment that it's possible to use for Lighthouse. So here are the Vive trackers, and you can use them for full body tracking. So two on your feet and one on your hip, and then you can use full body tracking. This is absolutely no problem. Or perhaps if you want to use the Hyper Blaster with a Vive tracker, this does work as well. Every equipment that is usable for the Lighthouse tracking, you can use with the Valve Index as well. This is really cool.
So let's check out the price for this headset. So the full kit, the headset, two controllers and two base stations are €1,079. Then you can buy a set with only the Index headset and the controllers. If you already have the base stations, then you pay €799. Then if you only want a headset, you pay €539, only the controllers €299, or only the base station €159. This is one base station. So for now you can only buy it at Valve over Steam. If there is later a possibility to buy it on Amazon, I don't know, for now only here. Okay, and let's talk about the final result of this stuff. So, as you can see, the Valve Index is very good, but not perfect. It's not the holy grail. So let's talk about the advantages and disadvantages. So, of course, the biggest advantage is the Index controller. This is flawless. This is perfect. This is VR how it should be. The Index controller are totally worth the complete hype. I can confirm that. Also the comfort, this is the most comfortable headset ever. The display is very clear, you can see everything very good. Screen door effect is there, but you don't notice it very much. It has the best sound ever and the best microphone ever, and the field of view is bigger than I expected. It's much better than with old Rift or old Vive. However, it has disadvantages like the God Rays. But the God Rays, you only notice them in different scenes where bright text is in front of dark background, for example. I played Onward in a bright map and I didn't even notice the God Rays anymore. So it only occurs in different scenes, like in Beat Saber when you see the big Beat Saber logo. Then the overheating of the headset is for me a problem, because I'm sweating a lot, and perhaps I hope they can fix that with an update. I don't know. I think this is a disadvantage. So what is the final result? So if you want to consider, will you buy the Rift S, the Vive Pro or the Pimax? I can tell you what is the best for you. So you should buy the Rift S if you want mobility. So you cannot just take the Valve Index with you, because you have to put the base stations everywhere and stuff. The Rift S you can just pull out and take it with you and put it in and then it's fine. So the Rift S is mobility, and also the price is much lower with the Rift S. It's only €450, but you cannot use the best thing of the index controller. This is not possible with the Rift S, perhaps with some hacks, but officially it's not supported. You have to consider that. So, if you want to use the Vive Pro, why should you buy the Vive Pro? So if you want OLED display and the best colors ever, then you should go for the Vive Pro. For me, the Vive Pro is too expensive because it has a small field of view, but you can use the index controllers with the Vive Pro. This is possible. Why should you buy the Pimax? So if you want the biggest field of view ever, that is available, then you should go for the Pimax. Also, the screen door effect with the Pimax 5K Plus and the 8K is the best. So if you don't care about the material quality or stuff, then you should go for the Pimax. However, guys, the complete package, if I consider what headset will I use in the future, so I will use the Valve Index, guys. I prefer the Vive, the complete package of the Valve Index over the Rift S, the Vive Pro and the Pimax. This is my final opinion. It's not perfect, as you can see, but the package, the controllers, this awesome controllers, the best comfort, the awesome sound, the clear display, this combination of all these advantages makes me think that the Valve Index is the best overall headset for now. So yes, I will play with the Valve Index in my future gameplays until there's a better headset. So guys, the price of course is a little bit too high. I would expect that the full package costs like 800 or 899 euro, not 1079, but it's still in the range that I would say, okay guys, it's okay. The headset alone is a little bit over 500. This is totally fine, but I think the base stations and the controllers are a little bit too overpriced, but all in all it's okay for me. So I hope I could help you with your decision what you should buy. Please guys, consider to support my work, if because everything is getting too expensive for me. I even have to consider if I cancel my order for the HP Reverb, because it's too expensive. I cannot afford this for longer, to be honest. Also, I get a new YouTube studio. This is also very expensive. So please consider to support me via Patreon. Only $1 per month would be enough. If you want to be official sponsor and mentioned in every video, you can even consider to put a $50 per month tier. That would be totally awesome. Or if you don't want to spend money on my work, then you can support me for free if you go on your Amazon orders via my link under the video, or via the Amazon Twitch Prime subscription that you can do for free every month on my Twitch account. Please consider that. That would be awesome so that I can continue to buy these expensive headsets. I hope you give me a thumbs up. That would be really cool. I would really appreciate that. And please subscribe to my channel so we can see all the future tests and gameplays. Thanks for watching and see you next time in virtual reality. See ya!